So let's begin our discussion with Epicurus, with what question Epicurus is trying to answer. And remember, all the philosophers, all the ethicists, we look at the semester, are answering the question, how should you live your life? But they're all going to answer that question by answering a different question, a second question. It's just, none of them are going to, if you're just going to answer the question, how should you live your life? They're probably just going to give you like a list of rules. Do this, do that, do this. But philosophers are interested in actually justifying these sorts of answers rather than simply just giving an answer. So to answer the question, how should you live your life? They're all going to ask and answer a second question, a different question. Now, remember with Hume and Sumner, they were each answering the question, how are moral beliefs justified? Hume said that moral beliefs are justified by the passions. What you desire, what you want, justifies your moral beliefs. Sumner had a different answer. And Sumner said the culture justifies moral beliefs. Then we went on to Glaucon. Glaucon is asking the question, whose interests are most important? And his answer is your own, right? Your own interests are most important. Therefore, justice is bad. Hobbes also was asking the question, whose interests are most important? But he had a different, he said your interests are also, he was agreeing with Glaucon saying your interests are most important, but he had a difference with Glaucon, right? Hobbes thought your interests are most important, therefore justice is good, because you can't survive on your own. Okay. So now we're at Epicurus. And so far we've had two different questions, right? How are moral beliefs justified? Whose interests are most important? All right. Is Epicurus answering one of those two questions? Or is he moving on to a different question?